Hello YouTube, Mikey Cal here, and this is video number 2 in my series on utilizing Blender as a video editor. Now if you're wondering how we got this layout over here, you need to watch video number 1 of my series where I walk you through configuring all of the optimal Blender settings for doing video editing. Now in today's video, I'm going to introduce you to the sequencer because I need to show you guys how to correctly import your source video files for editing. Now this area down here is the sequencer, and you'll notice that it is broken up into gray and dark gray rows that are numbered 0 through 7. Now in Blender, we actually call these rows channels, and if you want to see more channels, you can actually left-click on this little circle right here and drag up, and it will show you more channels. But let's leave it at the default of 7 for now. Now this green line that we see right here represents the current frame that is being viewed in the preview window. And if you want to see what the frame number is, you go down to this little box right here and it lists it. Now, if you left click on this green line and drag it across the sequencer, you'll notice that it will show whatever frame the green line is hovering over. And if you want to make it jump to a specific frame, you can just click on this box and type it in. We're going to return it to frame number 1. Now you want to start all of your projects at frame number 1 because it will actually import the video to wherever the green line is. So we want it to be at the first frame. Now there are two ways that you can import video files into your sequencer. One is to just open up your favorite file browser and drag and drop the video onto the sequencer. The other way is to use this add menu right here. Now we're going to click this and we're going to select movie, and we're presented with our files. And I'm going to select Tears of Steel. You can either select it by double clicking it, or you can click it once with your left mouse button and hit add movie strip. Okay, so what did we notice? First things first, we have two files, it looks like. They're not actually files, they're what we call strips. So it's actually divided our movie into two strips, one strip per channel. So we have the video, which is the blue one, and we have the audio on separate channels. Now the first thing you may have noticed if you're following along is that you have to click with your right mouse button to actually select a strip. This is something that a lot of people find counterintuitive, but it is done that way by design, and I would recommend that you actually just get used to it instead of going to your preferences and trying to change it. There is a setting in your file preferences to switch it to a left click select, but I promise you that there is a good reason why you want to do it this way, especially when you start using other parts of the program. So just get used to that. Now, we have the audio channel and we have the video channel, or we have the video and the audio on separate channels. And we can actually tell that this is audio because I can see a properties window over here and it has no dimension. Yet when I click on this blue strip, it actually has a dimension of 1280 by 534. So we know that that actually is an image. Now, what I noticed when I actually imported this, and something that you're going to have to pay attention to very closely when you start importing files into your sequencer, is these two numbers, you notice that they don't match. They should match. The audio and the video should have the same exact number of frames in order to be in sync with each other. Now, the reason why is because my frame rate by default is set to 30 frames per second. But this video is actually 24 frames per second. But guess what? We can fix that really quickly by simply going up to the frame rate dropdown and left clicking 24. And look at that. They now are perfect matches. So it will be in sync. Now, I also noticed when I clicked and selected this video strip that the dimension is 1280 by 534. Yet, if I look at my render settings up here, I have it set by default to 1080p because 9 times out of 10, I'm actually recording 1080p videos. But I want this to be rendered at the exact same resolution. So I can either take these two numbers and type them in as the X and Y values here by hand, or I can right-click on the video strip and go to the strip menu and select Set Render Size. And you'll notice that it actually has put in the correct resolution. And you notice it actually changed over here too, because it's going to display it at the correct resolution now. Now, that pretty much sums up all the things that you need to know about doing the import process. In the next video, we're going to go into more detail about what you want to do when it comes to editing in the sequencer. I'll see you next video.